It's not going to snow, it's going to rain.
Noah and the Ark. One day, long, long ago, God was looking down upon the earth, watching the men and women he had created, and he saw that they had become extremely wicked. They were robbers, murderers, cheats, liars, gossips, selfish, and in general, not very nice folks. The Holy God saw that every thought of man's heart was continually evil. So with a mighty sigh of grief, he decided to blot out every living thing off the face of the earth. But then God thought of Noah. Which translates, will you repeat that, please? Which translates, that's what I thought you said. Then God continued, yes, Noah, I will destroy the whole earth by bringing a great flood upon it. However, you and your wife, your three sons, and their wives, I will save. I will also save two of every kind of animal, bird, and creeping being that is upon the earth, male and female, and you are to gather them together. Now, I want you to build a boat. A very big boat. A very, very big boat. Which translates, how? So God gave to Noah all the instructions he needed to build the ark, and soon Noah and his three sons were busy hammering and sawing. Noah's wife and daughter-in-laws helped too. They would go for wood and help take care of all the animals. And during all this time, Noah's neighbors laughed at him and went on in their wicked ways. After many years, the ark was finally finished, and the Lord God came to Noah and said, it's time. Then Noah, very calmly, with a great deal of organization, went to get his family and the animals. The
vessels were probably first in line and very slow. And the kangaroos shook the ramp with their constant hopping. The squirrels were chattering away and always getting out of line. But finally, they all got into the ark, and God Himself shut the great door. Then it started to rain. It began with just a few sprinkles. Then it grew stronger. Then it began to pour. And it thundered. And lightning struck. And every living creature on the earth drowned. Except for Noah, his family, and the animals safe in the ark. Finally, the rain set a rainbow in the sky as a symbol of his promise never to destroy the earth again by flood. And every time we see a rainbow, it should remind us of Noah, his obedience and faith in God. God kept his promise to Noah, and he will keep his promises to all of us who believe and trust in him.